We're going to compute a integral from 3 to 5 of this square root x squared minus 9. Now this is 2.9, so it's hyperbolic trig. And going into the textbook, I've already zoomed into exactly where we need to be. Hyperbolic functions, okay. Keep scrolling, I want to see some derivatives and antiderivatives. So we're getting warmer. I see some derivatives here. So here's the derivative chart, and the antiderivatives are right underneath here. So there's going to be 5 of them. And I've already put them into the notes up above. I know I just showed that for 2 seconds. So now that you have a better idea of what this is, I'm going to write it as x squared minus 3 squared. Where are we? X squared minus 3 squared. We're going to do this Cauchy inverse right here. So I have all those up here. So we have 1 over square root u squared minus 1 du. I've already forgot what that is. Cauchy. There we go. C. Cos hyperbolic cosine. Cos hyperbolic inverse u plus c. Okay. All right, the big problem is we got a stupid 9 right there. So that we have to get rid of. Okay, let's do that. Let's ignore that right there. I'm not gonna write the integral in here. I'm just gonna do a bunch of algebra. And then we'll do all of our algebra to the left of this line, and then we'll do our calculus on the right side. So this will be our algebra zone. And then there'll be our calculus zone on the right. Okay, so I got to turn the 9 into a 1, no problem. So we're going to factor out a 9. Like that. And let's get that 9 outside the square root. So it's square root 9 times square root. That x squared over 9, you can write it as x squared over 3 squared minus 1. And then the last reduction step, that square root 9 is 3. And now x over 3, you can write it as x over 3 squared minus 1. So now we're ready to write our initial problem from 3 to 5, 1 over square root x squared minus 9 dx equals integral. That 3 can, 1/3 can be written out front. Okay, so all I did was algebra here. We got all that from our algebra zone right there. We're ready for a u substitution. We'll let u equal x over 3. Du is 1/3 dx. Bring the third to the other side is a 3 du. Oh, actually, oh, this is perfect. Look at that. We have a 1/3 dx. We don't have to bring the 1/3 to the other side at all. So we have integral 1 over square root u squared minus 1 du. Oh, that worked out really nicely. I'm happy. Okay. From here, what are we doing? We're ready to we have exactly this on the left at the top. This is cos hyperbolic inverse u plus c. Now I haven't written in the endpoints yet because we're over in a different variable called u. So let's unsubstitute. So x over 3. Now we're going from 3 to 5 plus c. So we have 5/3 minus cos hyperbolic inverse 3/3. We do not have a plus c, and why is that? because when you have endpoints, you don't have a plus c. I was just looking at what's at the top, but of course at the top we didn't have endpoints in that generic formula up there. Okay, that's it, and that should be your answer. Sometimes cosine hyperbolic inverse should be written as arc cosine hyperbolic, so be ready to type in either of those. So either one is okay to write.